We'll show how one can make use of the backend of a Wikipedia article. Each Wikipedia article is accompanied by a talk page where editors can discuss improvements to an article and an edit history where all revisions of an article are meticulously logged. Let's start with the talk page. And the talk page is also known as a discussion page and can be found by clicking talk page at the top left of an article. At the top of that page, you will see some general info and references to Wikipedia policies and guidelines. If a discussion thread has not received replies in the last 3 months, it will be archived, as you can see here, and I'll come back to this archive later on. Below the list of archived pages, one can search the threads for specific phrases of words. Thereafter, multiple templates are presented which indicate the status of the article and give some more meta information about the article. In this article, you can see, for example, that some of the topics are deemed controversial and that content may be disputed. One can also see when the article was featured, to which wiki projects it belongs, etc. Apart from discussions, the talk page can thus also list some information about the quality of an article and some further meta information. Beneath all this information, you can find the current discussions. In this case, there are only 5. Let us scroll back up and look at the most active discussions of the past. By clicking on Index in the list of archived pages, one can see an overview of all discussion topics, the number of comments made on that thread, as well as the permalink to that thread. And this view is often a good start to get an overview of the topics which sparked considerable discussion. When sorting this index by the most discussed threads, we can see that the topmost thread is about a requested move. Clicking the permalink to that thread, you can see that a lengthy discussion took place about the title of the article and whether the article should be renamed to Srebrenica genocide. And reading through such discussions will allow you to see all arguments made in favor or opposing such move. Let us return to the article itself. Apart from the talk pages, which can provide a lot of interesting information concerning the status of an article and the most disputed topics, each Wikipedia article also has a built-in edit history. And you can access this revision history by clicking on View History. On this page, one is presented with a list of all different edits to or revisions of a page. And let me skip this top part for now and show you how those different edits are represented. For each edit, you will see the exact date at which the edit was made, and clicking this would lead you to the version of the page as it existed at that time. The second field indicates which user made the edits, and again, clicking the username will lead you to the user's page on Wikipedia, about which more later. In between brackets, after the username, you can find links to the talk page of that specific user, as well as to a list of edits that the user has made on this language version of Wikipedia. The next column provides a number which indicates the size of the article in bytes, as well as the size of the change in bytes. And last but not least, you can see the comment with which the user has described the edit. And note that not all edits have a username attached. Whenever somebody who is not logged into Wikipedia edits a page, that editor's IP address is logged. So although for editors you can usually not find out whether where they are based, for anonymous users one can of course get an approximate geographic location through GeoIP tools. In this list of edits, you can also select any 2 versions of an article and inspect their differences. And when clicking Compare Selected Revisions, you will be presented with excerpts of the page which differ between the 2 versions. On the left side, you will see the earliest edit which you selected, and on the right side, the last edit which you selected. And here we can see that the latter edit moved a portion of the text of a specific section to a higher place in that section, so that it receives more prominence. And if you scroll down, you can also see that some changes were made to a specific section. And as you may imagine, comparing each revision with the previous one is an elaborate process, certainly given the fact that this article has more than 6,000 revisions. At the top of the edit history page, fortunately, there are some tools which allow you to get insight in the edit history more quickly. Let me start with the link which says View Logs for this page. And this list is basically the same as the previous one, but it has filtered out all patrol and review logs. It does list interesting moments in a Wikipedia article's history, such as when a page was locked or protected, moved, etc. Let us examine some more tools offered by Wikipedia. The first is the revision history statistics. It will show you things such as when the page was created and last updated, the number of edits involved in minor edits, in IP edits, bot edits, and also interesting is the number of edits made by the top percent of editors. For this article, you can see that 71% of the edits is made by the top 10% of most active editors. On the right side of the screen, you can also see some statistics on the pace of edits, how many other articles link to this page, etc. Scrolling down, you can see per year how many edits were made. Below that, you get more information about who were the most active editors and the most active bots. The bug section shows which sentences in the article are probably grammatically incorrect, as inferred by an automated tool. And even further below, there is an overview of the number of edits per month. Let's scroll back up for a second to the most active editors. Clicking the names of the editors will direct you to their user page. Clicking the top user Bosniak, we can see that he is actually blocked from Wikipedia. If we click the second user, we can see that the user has abusively used multiple accounts. We can also see that despite this personal abuse, the user has received a so-called barn star for continued attempts to improve the article. And although I won't detail barn stars and user pages here, note that user pages can be vastly different and often hardly contain any personal information. As such, it is thus often hard to find out whether the user is male or female, where the user is based, etc. Let's go back to the most active editors on the revision history statistics page. Particularly interesting here is the link called EC, the edit count, where you can find more information about the editing behavior of a particular user. So here you can see, for example, apart from some statistical information, and when edits were made by that user, that this user Bosniak was editing the Srebrenica massacre article the most, but that Bosniak also has edited a lot of related pages. So Bosniak is clearly a user which was invested in this issue and its related issue. So if we go back to the tool sections of the edit history of the article, we can also see that there is also a tool called Revision History Search. And here you can search when specific words or phrases appear in an article. So you could, for example, use this to find when genocide was mentioned in the article. And as it's a rather slow tool, I won't test its use here. Next tool, the Edits by User tool, allows you to zoom in on the edits made by one particular user. And similar functionality is actually provided when you click through from the history statistics page, which I showed earlier, so this tool might not be of much use. This tool, the number of watchers, actually does not do much either, as it just redirects you to the page information of the article and then indicates the number of watchers. The last tool offered on this page is the one with page view statistics. And with it, you do not inspect the number of edits, but the number of times a particular page has been viewed. The edit history and their tools does allow you to inspect the interesting moments in an article's lifespan and to inspect who actually edits the page. You can thus find out which users are heavily invested in the topic, what positions they take, and how dispute is resolved. When you delve into the edit history and talk pages of an article, you will notice that a lot of references are made to Wikipedia's apparatus. Apart from the core policies, neutral point of view, verifiability, and no original research, many other policies and guidelines may come into play. These policies often come into play to resolve a dispute and are thus definitely worth looking into. And in this video, I have focused on just one language version of the article, but most languages provide the same tools, and an interlanguage comparison of the different analyses introduced here should thus be straightforward.